Hi guys, so today I'm just going to show you how you can get professional looking results just using one single light source. Now in this case what I'm doing is shooting a product which has successfully been accepted by Getty Images, for which I'm a contributor. Now this product I'm shooting was requested by Getty for vaping products. So that's the new smoking devices that people seem to be using these days instead of cigarettes, and I'm one of these vapor users. So what I've done here now is to set up the simple studio look is using the light on the right hand side, as you can see coming through my window just over here, and that's quite a large window, so I've got plenty of light coming in. However, the light can change depending on the day, and it can be diffused 1 second and it can be really harsh the next second depending on the light coming through the clouds, or if it is cloudy, or if it is a complete sunny day. So at this point I've got, you can see the light shining straight through the window here, right down here, and it's hitting the table here. So what I've had to do is just move the surface and the product just into the shade slightly. I'm just going to zoom in on the image now just to show you. This is the product now on the table. The reflective surface I'm using here is a simple photo frame which I got in the shop, and I did use it for some images, but I've since taken the image out of it, and now I use this as a reflective surface for any product or still life photography that I may want to use with a reflective surface in it here, as you can see it here. For the light diffusion, especially if the light is really harsh, as you can see it is on the table over here, it's very red and it's very white and bright, so it's very, very bright sunshine coming through at this point during the shoot. So I've had to use some card. Now this is just plain normal white card, and I've created just a little frame for it, a little stand, just so the paper can stand up on its own. And the same applies for the background, it's a piece of black card. So if we zoom in the image, you can see a slight reflection down here, and you can also see a really nice light hitting a product and hitting the frame of the vaporizer itself. So it's not casting any harsh light and it's just really, really nice and defined. So moving on from that image, we can go and I can show you the shot that I've managed to take. Well, I've taken a few and I've submitted them all, and they've all been accepted by Getty, so that's good news. This is the actual shot. So from that setup, this is the kind of shot I've got. So you can see how nice and clear this band is around the battery compartment of the vaporizer, and you can see the lovely reflection at the bottom of the picture as well. Everything's nice and sharp and focused, and this was all was shot on my Nikon D750, and I used the 50-30mm lens at 30mm, and the settings on that were 1/60th of a second, and it was f7.1, and the ISO was set at 800. So there is a tiny bit of grain in the image, but that's okay. So we fit that one onto the screen, and I'll just go to another image and show you what I've got. There's the complete vaporizer. So when you zoom on this one, you can see a lovely light coming down this side of the image, so I'll just highlight it here in red. Lovely light down here on this side, and a slightly silvery light down this edge. Now the way I achieved that is to move the piece of paper which is on the, we'll go back to this image, move this piece of paper here, you can move it towards the camera over here, or away from the camera over here if you want to less light coming in or more light coming in. So what happens if you move the paper over this way, down this direction, you will get some light coming in, bouncing off the black card, and it will come in, it will come all the way over, it will bounce off this card and then back down onto the product this way. And that's what I did here. But as you can see, because the light is really harsh at the moment, at the time I took this shot, I've kept the card, this piece of card over here, yeah, right up against the black background. And the reason I did that, because I didn't want any really bright light hitting the product. And then going back into the image itself, you can see how it's lit nice and evenly just by creating that thing there. So this is another image that I've taken, and what I've done this time is I've moved the card slightly further away, so over this way from the background. So the card is coming this way, the white card, and the other one is right next to the background, just so we can bounce some light off of this edge bit separating from the background. And you can see that the background in this image is slightly grey than it was black. Now you have to be careful when you're shooting these kind of products, because you don't want any reflection from the camera in any reflective surfaces on the product. In this case is this like strip that I have on the vaporizer, and you want a nice crisp clear light around these areas just to bring out the definition. So if you zoom in on there, you can see it's lovely and clear. You can tell that it's really well exposed, and it's got lovely light and reflective light bouncing off it, and even on the dripper itself with the juice, it's really nicely separated from the background with this nice white strip going around it, which is kind of like a rim light around the product. And even up to the dripper handle itself, you can see the texture and contour in it there, which is very nice. Now that's probably, I've turned the white card slightly at 45 degree angle, just bouncing it off here, and again that's created like a grey and lighter grey background over here and here, and then again it's darker here, and it's also really dark down the bottom. That's just the way I wanted it. So moving on to another image, we have this one, which is the vapor line on the side. Now the reason I shot it at 7.1 and I was close to the actual product itself is because I just wanted this bit in focus. I didn't want any of this in focus because I've got that in the other image. So it was just about retaining the detail at the front of the, well, the top of the vaporizer here as well. So the mouthpiece that you use to get the vapor out, and just to highlight the liquid in the vapor as well. So it's a lovely reflective surface down here, and it's really nicely lit just over here where you can see that the light has come in and just hit this piece here really, really nicely. And again, it kind of separates the product from the background, the foreground of the product from the background, which is really handy. So let's just go back now and have another look. So there's the main scene. You can see really bright sunlight coming in, really harshly hitting it here, and I've left this white paper here just to show you how harsh the light is hitting that. It's so white and bright and overexposed, and that's why I've used the card here. And then in this image you can see where I've kind of hidden the light away from the product, but it's still coming through. And the only piece that I focused on are bits in here, so it's just here where the camera is framed in order to create this image right here. So that's how you can create professional looking product photography, and you can use this for still life, fruit and food. It's really good as well, which helps to just bounce the light where you want it and helps you produce professional looking studio quality images without the need for expensive studio lights and flashes and stuff like that. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you need any more tips and advice, then please do get in touch. Please give this video a thumbs up, and if you like what I do, please subscribe to my channel. That'd be great. Thanks very much for watching, and I'll see you all again soon. Take care. Goodbye.